Hello, this is Florina Kitasakana, and I'm back with episode 24 of Let's Play Epic Battle Fantasy 4. In the last episode, I went and took on the boss rush. Well, not the boss rush, but I did that off screen. I took on all the upgraded foes and the dark enemies on Epic Mode, and now we will take on the final boss. And I will be changing equips in battle. But the current setup I have is Matt has the Equilibrium and the Golden Armor, as well as the Golden Pentagram. Nats has the Pope outfit and Silver Rosary. And Lance remains unchanged. So, and we're good on food stocks, hopefully. So, let's go here. Oh my god. It's Godcat. Why are there two of them? Does she have two bodies? She doesn't look so tough. We're a lot stronger than we were last time we fought her, but I guess there are two of her now. That could change things. I'm too young to die. That's how I know we can win. It's too late to change our minds now, so we better get ready. This is going to be our greatest battle yet. And yeah, you can fight these kitten soldiers if you want, but they don't yield much. Clicking on either of these icons will trigger the battle. Okay. There's two of them, so you need to start buffing during this phase. And I mean, start buffing. Buff everything. I was expecting you. What do you feel you can accomplish? Filthy humans! Your fortitude is an obscenity. Do you think you can defeat your god? Yes I can. With a straight face. So she knew I was going to show up. You humans have savagely murdered my children and conquered my lands. Perhaps you forget who it is you owe your existence to. Bow down to the power of your creator! Those tails are dangerous. Yeah. Jesus! That attack she just did has the potential to dispel your buffs. And And she seems to hate Lance for some reason. Sister was bugging me. I need cayenne. I already did. Humans grew in strength, slowly but surely, while my children grew weaker. My children have failed to hold the dominance of the earth. And so I punish them so that they may never forget the shame that I felt as their mother. I don't think that was exactly the right approach. I'm just saying. Yeah, she's more physically... No, she's more magically oriented than she is physically oriented. Yeah, I'm going to have to Ragnarok to get rid of most of her helpers. And what the hell? I think... Yeah. Alright, so one of her helpers has to doom. Thanks for holding out for me, Matt. Okay, she hates lightning. Water, bomb, earth, and darkness. She doesn't use too many holy attacks. Another sword tail. go. That's how it's done. And you can also poison her. Let's do that. Have to amp up that resist. I created humans to be used by cats to provide a workforce, a source of sustenance. Humans were meant to be naught but slaves. It was a mistake to give them free will, a mistake I shall rectify with humanity's complete annihilation. She seemed to be in favor of elemental things. Okay, Nancy's at limit break. I'm going to use that lemon break immediately. Giga Drill. Ragnarok! This again? This is becoming a bit problematic. I seem to have died. Okay, I'm going to build up my skill points. Be right back. Alright, I'm back. I ground all the way to level 35. And I upgraded everything. The zombie hydra heads that you find in the cemetery, those are great EXP farms and skill point farms, as well as money farms. Yeah. Let's try this again. Thank you. That's how it's done. There we go. Gonna heal. May as well summon the monolith. Woo! That's a lot of damage. And she has two clothes. I'll fix that! Pulsar. Yay. And you just had to bring out the monolith, didn't you? That's okay, Flora can fix that! They have three sword tails, an ancient monolith. There she goes. I am changing in preparation of the next arc. And here comes the next part. Aeons ago, there were countless civilizations far greater than any of today. They built towers to the heavens and were capable of magnificent technology. I have ruined them all, effortlessly. You feeble creatures are nothing to me! Just a cat, I can handle this. Yeah, Lance is freaking out. Did she resist the spell? Not much, okay. Lance's hit limit break. Yeah, this one's more physically oriented. And it seems she does not like Lance. Okay, who got slippery? Okay, the evil tail got siphoned. Now it's his hit limit break. Yeah, she's got low HP. She is going to use Supernova. And it's not going to be pretty. Any species that defies its purpose will return through the dust from whence it came. Humans are a plague on this world, a plague that must be purged with hellfire. Nothing can stand in my path of death and destruction. I'm standing in your path of death and destruction. What are you? Hey, at least you're putting forth effort. That's something. Yorg. Zombie kittens! Matt's about to hit his limit break. And there goes Dark Godcat. Hooray for auto revive. Gonna start buffing again. I'm gonna set up the morale status. gonna have to sacrifice the MP. But it's a trade-off I'm willing to make. Because you're gonna face both forms. Not with that attitude. I think Matt's hit limit break. I can't be too sure though. I know Nat's gonna hit hers. Yeah, there he goes. Never mind. Yeah, I'm stuck playing the waiting game. Really? Fucking hell, Matt. Bring in Lance. Oblivion! That supernova. I'm summoning the dragon. I know it heals the creator, but fuck, if it gets rid of the destroyer, I'm all for it. Do your thing. Whoa. She didn't even even get a chance to use absolute zero. Yeah, don't do anything. Perhaps I was mistaken in judging you, Perhaps I was mistaken in judging humans so harshly. I see now the magnitude of your strength, wisdom, and courage. I had always wished for cats to exhibit these qualities, but it was never meant to be. I accept that humans have earned this world. Interesting. Your strength is but a fraction of my own, and yet, in the face of certain death, you humans are determined to fight for existence. I shall spare your pitiful lives and will instead observe how your story develops from now on. I'm sure we'll meet again. And holy Jesus. After a long and grueling battle, it seemed that the party was going to be defeated by the immortal Godcat. However, Godcat began to feel some empathy towards the humans. She had always wished for cats to become this strong, and was saddened by the realization of her failure as a mother. Godcat finally realized that this world she had created no longer belonged to her. It belonged to the humans now, and they would do anything to protect it. Godcat's abandoned children had grown powerful enough to rebel against their creator more than the cats ever could. This world did not unfold as she had desired. And so, Godcat departed once more into the vastness of space in search of a new world to call her home. With a better understanding of her own limitations, she would not make the same mistakes again. She would continue on her quest to create the perfect world for cats. The cats that had brought together the jewels and summoned Godcat were recognized for their bravery. They ascended into the heavens along with their mother and would seed the population of their world. Nolex was also given the chance to go on Godcat's journey, but he had refused the offer, as he already had a home here. Yeah, I like that. That was a pretty good ending. Look. Huh? What's this? It looks like we can restart the game without losing all our stuff. Yay! And there you have it. That is the end of Epic Battle Fantasy IV. It was a pretty awesome game. Sure, it was challenging on Epic Mode, yes, but that was the whole point of it. The storyline, it was pretty good. Could have used some tweaking here and there, but is what I first thought, but as I played the game and everything fell into place, the true story began to unfold, and it was just, well, on epic proportions. The music was great, fitting, the foes, the skills, everything. It was just, wow. And so ends the tale. This is Florina Kita Satina, bidding you adieu.